high time to bring out a solid body version for the Streamliner. So we're calling these the Junior Jet Clubs, and they're really stripped down rock and roll machines. Just real simple slab body. This is a NATO body, solid NATO body. It's got a bolt-on neck with a NATO neck on there. NATO is a relative of mahogany, so it has a very similar tonal sound to mahogany, and also the weight is very similar and the feel and everything. Yeah, so we've moved over to the Electromatic corner of the Gretsch booth here at NAMM 2020, and the guitar you're looking at right now is our new Double Jet BT. So the Electromatic Jet series, we upgraded the single cutaway models a year or two ago, and then in summer NAMM we introduced the Double Jet FT, which is a version FT meaning Filtertron pickup. So they have Filtertron pickups and Bigsby's, and then so the BT version is the one with the Broadtron pickup. And our Broadtron pickup guitars come with the V stop tail instead of the Bigsby. And these are the Centerblock Junior models. So these were this model, the Centerblock Junior was first introduced last year. We had gold hardware on those models. It was a green, a blue, and an orange one. So now we've introduced a nickel hardware version. Again with those Broadtron pickups, Bigsby this time, you've got the licensed B70 unit on the back there. And these being center blocks, they have a spruce center block all the way down the middle. These are really cool. New addition to our hollow body range, Electromatic hollow body range, is the Ratrod models. We call them Ratrod because it's like we've stripped down hot rodded vibe of these guitars compared with our regular hollow body models. First off, they have the satin finishes. We put these little red inserts into the pickups to give it a hot-rodded vibe. They're still what we call our blacktop Filtertron pickups, but they have the red inserts. Black pickguard there. They're also, the bodies are thinner. So on our regular hollow bodies, they're 2¾ inches thick. These are 2¼ inch. Doesn't sound like much, but when you pick one up, you really feel the difference. Medium jumbo frets. These have got rosewood fretboards. This particular one, the white satin, has got the contrasting black binding, which is, I think, really stunning. Secured bridge, Bigsby, licensed Bigsby B60, Graphtec Newbone nut, got the matched headstock with the binding on there. It's just a great guitar. I can see the people playing these guitars, you know, getting them all battered up, putting stickers on them, you know, modding them, doing all sorts of crazy stuff to them, making it their own.
Thank you. This is my favorite Gretsch I've ever played.
Hello, Key Music viewers. You're completely right at the Pearl booth at NAMM. So I'm show you some nice, cool things which we have this year. Number one is the new Eliminator Solo pedal. So we have actually two versions. Show here. It's good here. A Solo Black. There's a black cam. The black cam is a linear cam for a more natural and standard power feel. And we have a second version, that's the red cam, that's a radical progressive cam. And this simple provides more speed. So for the guys who needs more speed, more lighter, the red one is the right one. For the more standard and power guys, the black one is the right one. What we have done, we have designed a completely new footboard, resistance free and light. And then we have adapted simple some existing things of the Eliminator, for example, the power shifter system is included, and the hoop clamp from the Eliminator is included, and the spring tension as well. So the idea of the single brace was simple. It should be a stable and sturdy hardware. That's what everyone accepts from Pearl, and that's what we are famous for stable hardware. So we simply took our 930, existing 930 hardware series, and just keep the tubing, completely tubing. That's everything like the 930. Just the tripod is single brace instead of double brace, and that at the end it really has a is a reliable, durable and lightweight stand. Everything is available in that hardware line. Simple boom stand, a straight stand, a snare stand, and a higher stand. The drummer who buys a solo pedal, that's the matching high stand for him. We all know that's a very important thing, that everything is smooth on the left side. So, and then we have another solution, a third solution over here for the drummer who don't like the traditional double braced high stands. We have for the guys who buy a solo pedal, Elementor solo pedal, a double braced high stand here as well. With the footboard of the solo pedal, the H10030. So here you see nice setup of a decked maple. This is actually a new color from the US. It looks like a standard setup, but here on the side of the floor tom, there is hidden a very, very, very nice detailed feature. Look here, this is our new cymbal attachment. How cool is that? How cool is that? You can simply fix it on the floor tom leg. Yeah, these are the small details Pearl take care of, and all the drummers will love. These are our four hardware solutions for drummers. Hope you like it, and check it out at Key Music.
Have a new version of our classic HD25 series, a new model called the HD25 Lite. This has the classic HD25 driver for all that great sound that people have loved over the years, with a streamlined headband that helps really, you know, keep it simple, keep it light and easy to use. For wired microphones, we're showing off a brand new concept mic that'll be released later in the year. That's designed, our engineers really, we tasked them with something really important, which is how do we solve the problem of the feedback on stages? So they really worked hard to come up with a high rejection microphone that sounds exceptional, but really works well with the large stages that have large thrust areas that go out in front of the PA and create challenges with feedback and pickup of both speakers and crowd noise. And then the last thing that's new from Sennheiser at the show is we've really enhanced our digital wireless series called Digital 6000. So what Digital 6000 does, this is our flagship, you know, digital wireless series that you see out on tour around the world. Globally, there are heavy challenges with digital dividends, you know, spectrum being repurposed for the uses for data for cell phones. So for a production, there's now a need to have more wireless channels fit into less space. So we've added as a free upgrade, that can just be downloaded and loaded into all your Digital 6000 systems, a new firmware that allows you to activate a new mode that allows you to operate all the wireless links tighter together.
Hey everybody, my name's Steve, I'm from Blackstar UK and I'm reporting here for Key Music. This is one of our new products for NAMM 2020, it's the Sonnet Acoustic Amps from Blackstar. I'm just going to run you through some of the details. So this is the 60 watt version, we have two combos, 60 and 120. I'm going to run you through the front panel. We've got two channels, one dedicated for guitar, one dedicated for either a guitar, instrument, or microphone. So this is going to be very typical of what you'll be used to be seeing with an acoustic amp. So we've got our EQ, we've got a reverb and a gain input. We've got a phase switch and a shape, so we can give ourselves a little bit of a different EQ, or we can invert the phase there to get a slightly different sound or deal with a little bit of feedback. In this master area, this is where it gets a little bit interesting. Okay, so we've got two types of reverb, hall and plate. We've got reverb levels for each channel, but what is really nice is we've got control, overall control of our reverb time, so we can adjust the decay of the reverb.
PIA stands for, it's an acronym for Paradise in Art. And it's the new Ibanez signature model for Mr. Steve Vai.
Yeah.
And all of us at Ibanez are very excited. We've been working on this for a few years now with Steve very closely, going over all the aspects, and we all feel it's a great successor, not even a successor, but a great counterpart to the Ibanez Gem. Steve always had, even in the beginning of the Ibanez Gem, when developing it, he always had an idea that it would evolve and change, but it never really did after decades. And I think after the 2017 NAMM show, when we were celebrating 30 years of the Gem, Steve approached us and he said, you know, guys, I had some ideas in mind. I think it's time. I think we've had some great success with the Gem. But, you know, let's play a little bit. Let's have some fun. Let's see what we can come up with. And, you know, a few years later, here we are with the new PIA model.
Yeah. Let's take one, because they look astonishing, man. They look
right.
First of all, what it's all about, I think, is this, the new grip. Yeah. Tell me about it.
Yeah, so that's the new pedal grip. Steve named it the pedal grip because to him, it reminded him of the petals of a flower. You know, it kind of has a falling effect. And that's where this, you're right, that's the most eye-catching feature of the new PIA model. And we took the pedal grip and we ran with it. And you'll find the pedal grip, the shape, kind of interwoven into the entire design of the PIA model. And we think that's really cool. It's something that you can best describe as like a synergistic effect of the guitar. The bevels are a little bit more round than the Gem was. That was something Steve definitely wanted to do with the PIA. He wanted to kind of just take the Gem and round it over, make it a little smoother, a little bit more organic feeling.
And the pickups, those are newly designed DiMarzio pickups?
Yes, these are the new DiMarzio Utopia pickups. They're completely new. Not only are they new aesthetically, but they're also completely a new tone. They were tone-shaped with Steve and DiMarzio. He went back and forth over a lot of prototypes, and Steve found what he feels is the pickup set that's the best suited for this new instrument.
Yeah. And what shape is it? Is it a D?
Yeah. It's a little bit. It's similar to the Gem neck, it's made pretty much similar to the Gem neck.
Yeah. And the radius?
The radius is 16, just like the Gems were. Yeah.
Something about the backside, which is awesome. This is awesome. Yeah. Tell me about it.
Yeah. So this is cool. This is very cool. This is like a secret. It's not as apparent as the pedal grip, but once you turn the guitar back, you're like, oh, what is this?
Yeah.
So something Steve really wanted to do was, Steve likes to really tinker and play with things, and he's always looking for a better way to do something. And one of the ideas that he had was to come up with something to make it easier to get into the tremolo cavity. And what we were able to figure out is this very cool feature. So now, instead of having six screws, or this apply with six screws, it's simply magnets now, which you kind of kick yourself. You're like, why isn't anybody?
That's what I wanted to ask.
We did it now.
It's genius, man.
And it's great. It's super easy. It's off. It's on like that. So anytime you need to do a spring adjustment, it takes a matter of a fraction of a second, as opposed to minutes, to take off the old six screw back cavity plate.